your sins and you've accepted Christ have been dealt with. Let that settle in. I'm just going to kind of teach you a little bit today. Your sins, if you are saved, they have been dealt with on the cross 2,000 years ago.
Thank you, God.
You are no longer under the penalty of sin.
Thank you, God.
Because the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. All right? Your sin's been dealt with. Now what happens a lot of times is people get satisfied if their sin's being dealt with. And they don't serve. When you get saved, you are supposed to surrender to God's will.
That's right.
You are not supposed to be my will, but thy will be done. And so you do that by presenting your body as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is our reasonable service. You with me so far?
Yes, sir.
So you want to be able to look back over your life, and you want to be able to see what you have sacrificed and done for the Lord.
Yes.
If I was to ask you to take out a pen and a piece of paper and tell you to start writing, not arrogant, but humbly, what you've done for the Lord since you got saved. Would it be a sentence? Would it be a paragraph? Would it be just one page? Would it be several pages? Could it fill up a chapter? Could it make a book? Since you've been saved, think about how many years you've been saved. Or think about how long you've been saved. Have you been working for the Lord? And when I say working for the Lord, I want you to think in terms of like you get up and you go to work. And you go and you do. Do you do like that for the Lord? When you go to work, you don't think about it dragging on and on and on and on often. A lot of times people get to work, they be cheerful. Perked up, they be happy a lot of times. And some folks go complaining. I wish I didn't have to work. And then I go and see them laying up somewhere, wishing they could get up and go to work. Be thankful for whatever job you got. Amen. And what are you doing for the Lord? The reason I raise that question is because this Sunday, as you know, is Advent. Advent candle has been lit. The theme for the first Sunday, God is going to have his kingdom. And that's why we dealt with those scriptures. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Okay? So what does that mean? All that you do for the Lord is what's going to last. All what you do for the Lord is what's going to last. And when we get to heaven, and when we come down to reign with him on the earth, what you've been doing now is going to determine what you're going to be doing then. If you're not doing nothing now, see, because only what you do for the Lord is going to last. You've been in Sunday school. You've been hearing in Revelation 21, there's going to be a new heaven and a new earth. Everything that you see is going to pass away. Are y'all hearing that?
Yes.
What are you going to be doing for the Lord? Now, very briefly, I just want you to understand this. There's going to come a time when the Lord is going to reign over the earth. The next event that we're looking forward to on the Christian calendar is the trump of God to sound. The dead in Christ shall rise first, then we which are remain shall be caught up to meet them in the air. And the Bible says, so shall we ever be with the Lord. As soon as we leave, the tribulation is going to start. That's a 7-year period. You can read more about that in Revelations. Just say, after the 4th chapter, verse 1, we're going to be raptured out. The judgment's going to come. And then, we're going to go through, those that are here go through the time of tribulation, 7 years. Jesus is going to come back to earth in chapter 19 of Revelation. He's going to set up his millennial reign, which of course is 1,000 years. We're going to be with him in our resurrected body. The Bible tells us we'll be kings and priests ministering unto him. The book that I was dealing with today in Isaiah, that 2nd chapter, verse 1 through 5, read over that. That deals with the millennial reign of Christ. Okay? 1,000 years, and he's going to be reigning on earth. Every enemy, every tongue spoke up against him, going to be squashed. Then he's going to come. The devil will come out for just a little while. He's going to let him out. And after he comes out for a little while, there's going to be a war. The devil will be defeated. We already got the end of the story. And then after that, there's going to be a judgment, a great white throne for those who never accepted Christ. Everyone whose name is not written in the Lamb's Book of Life will go to hell. Hell will be cast into the lake of fire. We will not have to worry about that judgment because we have accepted Christ, those of us that have. And then we saw the new heaven and the new earth. So why am I telling you all this? Brothers and sisters, when we leave here today, simply leave with a mindset that whatever I need to be doing for the Lord, realize the devil don't mind you thinking about it just as long as you don't do it. I'm not telling nobody to quit your job. I'm telling you to leave here today and go do whatever it is that you've been doing, with one exception. Whatever it is that the Lord wants you to do, if he's saying, no, don't do this, do this. Make up in your mind, Lord, I need your help while I'm doing it. Amen?
Amen.
Whatever it is. When I came here to Center Baptist, I came here to serve. I have a secular job. I said, okay, Lord, I saw you got me installed as pastor. This is what I know. This is my calling. This is what you want me to do. I'm going to stay on this job till you tell me otherwise. 6 months later, they wanted me to start lying on the job. Well, he didn't have to crack heaven's sky and say, okay, now is that your sign? I knew I wasn't going to be lying Monday through Friday and come in here and try to preach on Sunday. So it was time to go. So I resigned. So I left. You got to be just as willing to stay as you are to go. Whatever it is the Lord wants you to do. Are you hearing me? Because as we go forth in 2017, it's no telling what all God's going to lay on your heart and needs to be done here at Center Baptist and beyond. And you need to be ready to go do whatever it is he wants you to do. That's it. All hearts and minds are clear. Hope that you can make it over there to Gold Hill at 3 o'clock. If you need directions, let us give them to you. Let us stand. Leave out of here with a mind to serve God. Because only what you do here is going to last for the Lord. Everything else is going to be burned up and gone. With it, let us receive a benediction. Now may the sweet communion of the blessed Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide henceforth now. and forevermore. And all of God's children say amen. Hug somebody and let me get one. Sayings on the road, management. Like me with everyone right over here. Higgins. While me and the choir room for Jess Man. Talk